Hello friends, welcome back. And today we are going to discuss about the database connections in the Python. So in this series of Python, for next three videos, I will discuss about the database connectivity and how you can work with the database, how you can create the procedures, how you can insert, update, delete the data from the database tables. All those things we will discuss one by one. Okay, so before you start with the code, I would like to tell you that you need to install MySQL on your system before you can use it, because I have used MySQL on my system and this is a freeware, so you can just install the MySQL server and then you can just start your coding, right? So I have the software MySQL installer community 8016.0. You can just download it from the MySQL site, and from after installing from there, you just need to install on your machine this server and the MySQL workbench. This is MySQL workbench, which is a client tool to run the queries and to get the fetch the data from the database and all that, and to insert the data into the database just like you do with other database client tools. So this is one of the GUI based tool, which is MySQL workbench. Okay, so let's start. So MySQL workbench, basically I have just connected with my database to the server, not to the database, to the server. Let me show you that how we connect to it. So here is like MySQL workbench, and you just need to start as an administrator. I usually start every application as an administrator. So after starting it, you will be able to see that it will ask you about the database username and password. So the username is root for my database and the password is test123. So using that password and username, I will just connect to it. So you can see this is the root. This is how it looks like when you start the database workbench, MySQL workbench. It will look like this. So here, if you click, then it will ask you the root password. So the password is test123 for my server. You can choose any password of your choice. I have chosen test123. Okay, so here I have connected to the database server, not to the database. So here I'm just going to create one database so that I can do other things, like I will create the database table and then I will just insert the data into the database. So I'm just going to create it. So this has now been created. Once it is created, you need to refresh it. And once you refresh it, you will be able to see that the MyTestDB database is visible here, right? There are no tables as of now. So we will create those tables using the code. So first of all, before you use the MySQL, you need to install the MySQL connector on your system. And for installing that, you need to use this command, pip install MySQL connector Python. This command you need to run on your command prompt. Before you write any code, you need to run this command, pip. PIP install MySQL connector Python. Once you run this command, you will be able to see something like this. And if you get this message, successfully install MySQL connector Python 8.0.21, then in that case, you can understand that it has been successfully installed. Otherwise, there are some issues. If there are issues, just correct them and install it again, right? So this is the first thing you need to do before you write any code. And before that, you need to install the database server, MySQL server, and the MySQL workbench. Okay, so MySQL server, MySQL workbench, and after that, run this command so that you can install the MySQL connector Python. Without this, you will not be able to do the connection to the database, and you will not be able to write any code to connect to database or to perform any operation with the database tables or anything else which is related to the database. Okay, so we have just installed. After installing it, you don't have to do anything. Just need to open your IDE, just like my IDE is IDLE. So I'm using this simple IDE. So later on, I will show you something on the PyCharm as well, once the course will be completed, so that you can understand that how PyCharm use. Because PyCharm is basically a heavy kind of IDE. So I am not using that, because my purpose is to just let you know that how you can code. And later on, we will see that how PyCharm can be used. Okay, so here what you will do, first of all, you will do this thing, import mysql.connector. And after that, you will create a connection. This is the variable name. You can choose any name, and then you need to write like mysql.connector.connect. And then you need to provide four arguments. First is localhost, the server name. So my server name is localhost. If I'm trying to connect to some other server, then I need to give the name of that server here. And after that, I need to give the name of the database. If you see here, I have created the database with name, mytestdb. So I have given this name here, mytestdb. And after that, my user was root and the password was test123. So with this, my database, my code has been connected to the database. If it is connected to the database, then there will be no problem. No issue will be visible on your screen. And then here I have just presented that I have connected to the database, and here I have just printed the MyDB server version, which means that here I'm printing about the database version of the MySQL server, and then here I'm opening the cursor. Before working to the database, you need to open a cursor with that database. And to open a cursor with that database, you just need to use this connection, and you need to call the cursor function to open a cursor with the database. Using this cursor only, you will be able to perform many operations to the database, right? So here what I'm doing here, I'm just trying to execute one command, select database. So here what I'm trying to do, I'm just trying to select that database to which I have connected here. So here I have connected to the MyTestDB. So here in this query, I'm just trying to select that database to which I have connected, right? So here I have just fetched the first record. Fetch one means only one record you need to fetch, and that is the top record, right? So if I have connected to one database, then it will return only one. So the top record will be the record related to MyTestDB. So here the record will come, and then it will print a message connected to database, and then it will be the database name. Okay, and then I'm just going to create a table here. Create the table with name, like ID, name, and department, DEPT. So I'm going to create a table with name employee, not employee details. I'm going to create a table with name employee, and this will contain three columns, ID, name, and department. So here what I'm doing, here I'm just running a query. You need to take care of the indentation. So if the connection is alive, which means that connection is connected, we are connected to the server, database server, then in that case, I'm just going to execute one query, which is to create a table. So I'm just going to create a table whose the name of the table is employee, and it has three columns, the ID, the name, and the department. So ID is of type int, and the name is of type varchar32, which is a character data type, and then we have department, which is again a character data type. So this is the way I can create a new table, the name employee, and then after it will be created, then we are going to just insert new records in the employee table. So as of now, I'm just going to comment this section where we are just going to insert new records so that we can just see that how the database table will be created and how it will look like. And then we will just insert these records into the database. Okay, and then we will see that whether these records have been inserted into the database table or not, right? So here just need to run it. So once I run it, it will perform all the things, like it will display the database details to which I have connected, and then it will just create a table then with the name employee, right? So it has displayed me the DB server version here, and then it has displayed the connected to the database message, the name of the database, right? So here is the name of the database, MyTestDB. And then what we will do, then we are going to do this thing. If connection is connected, then we are just going to execute create table employee ID, name, and department with these columns. Okay, so this must have been created because this piece of code is also here. So this must have been executed. And then if we see here, if we refresh it, and then if we see it, then what will happen? Oh, there is no column, there is no value inserted because this was commented. So we can just see that this table is there. So you can see that employee table is there. Now we are going to just insert the records. So we are just going to remove this comment, and then we will be inserting the data into the database table. So let's see. But now this time, since we are going to insert the data into the database table, and the table is already created, so I'm just going to comment this section because it will give me an error because table is already created, right? So I'm just going to comment it, and I will just insert the data into the database table. Okay, so here I have executed four insert statements. So for the first one, 1000 is the ID. For the second one, 1001, 1002, and then 1003. These are the IDs and these are the names. Two of these employees are in sales department and two of them are in the marketing department. So I have inserted four records into the database table. And after that, just remember that after executing these insert statements, you must need to call this commit statement on this connection. Until you call commit on this connection, you will not be able to see any record into the database. So if I just comment it, and if I just run this application, then if you want to see whether the record has been inserted or not, then you can see that these records have not been inserted, right? So we can come here and we can just refresh it. And if we just run it, select query, then you can see that there are no records visible here. Why? Because we have not committed the records. So you need to commit the records on the connection, right? So once you commit on the connection, then all those activities which you were performing, like whether it was inserting or it was like updating any record or it was like deleting any record, every kind of thing you need to commit over the connection. If you don't commit it, it will not execute. It will not be persisted in the database table. It will not persist into the database tables in the database, right? So if I run it now and then if we go to the workbench and then we try to look into the records, then you can see that the records are coming, right? So you need to remember these things. And this is a very simple code, and there is no problem you will face while communicating with the database using the Python program, right? So this is a very simple program, and it's a very simple use of database connectivity through the Python, right? So in the next video, you will see that how we can update a record, how we can select the records from the database, how we can delete, update, all those things we will see. Until then, have a nice day. Bye-bye. And please like, subscribe my channel and share my videos. Bye-bye.